Hello everyone, and welcome once again to Let's Play Skyrim. Last time when we left off, we were making our way through Chillwind Depths.
Who's there? That'll teach you.
And that's still what we're doing this go-round. We're in the easy portion of the dungeon involving spiders. You'll also remember that after a little bit of grinding, we got illusion to 90. Which means that all of my benchmarks or prerequisites for my build all the way up to level 81 are met.
Who's there? That'll teach you.
And it's now a very simple matter of maximizing all of my skills in order to get all of the experience. There's our first palmer. This is quiet casting kicking in. That's why he doesn't actually know where I am, even though he's searching for me. Serana, get out of the fucking way, for real. In what universe is that helpful? Getting between me and the enemy. There's 61 destruction, 39 ranks to go. Oh look. I can refill my magicka this way.
Who's there?
There we go. That worked okay. There's 92 restoration. Can't forget I need to finish maxing that as well. But all things in due time. Search those Falmer and the platforms they were on. And now that we've cleared some danger back here, I think we can do a little bit more proper search of these side passages. Let's start with this first left that was available that we skipped because I saw those enemies down the hall. What do we have in here? An apprentice locked chest. With some gold in it. And another tunnel. Jesus, Serana. It spits us out right back here. Got that cleared out, which means there's now only one way to go. tons of mushrooms in here. There's a pressure plate trap that I'm sure Serana will trigger. Annoyed by our refusal to hang out in this room. It's like, come on. All the mage did was immediately run away. I'm just gonna hang out in here and recover for a bit. Asking for the basket. Come on, game. Look at all this nonsense. Okay. Well, I think we've got all that at least. Oh, come on. Sometimes you just make me say, fucking really? And that is one of those times. Alright, good, we got the mage. Out of the fucking way. God damn it. I don't know how I'm ever supposed to do anything if my so-called allies are blocking me from retreating so that I have no choice but to get chewed on by another fucking Charis. It's like, come on. Oh. There's 72 handed. That's good. Oh, there's an ore vein right here. Try that again, once more, with feeling. Still more mushrooms. Do not run away. Unacceptable. Tunnels clear. Looks like we got one more enemy hanging somewhere in here. Iron ore, charis chitin. Yeah, no, I need to keep my magicka for healing. See, that worked. Now then. I thought we were finally out of red dots, but I'm wrong. There's still another one. I do think we can at least search this room now. Keep just spotting a place where I can grab it. There. Don't need any of that. Here goes.
heard you.
Oh, he should have been dead. Well, at least I know he's coming now. Oh, for fuck's sake, Serana, why? Maybe I don't want to fight two more enemies right now. Does that ever occur to you? Nope. Onward you march. Tactics be damned. Well, this one is just a Falmer. Him, and actually that solid Dwemer metal is something I want. That's a useful item.
Knew it.
Christ, lady. Let me loot these tunnels first. So here's where the lower one rejoins the upper one. Just leaves this Charis pen. Which is thankfully already empty. Oh, just kidding. Two-handed, that's good. There's a dead person named Furier, who somehow got reanimated. A dead Skulker. Another Skulker. Are we done now? More accurately, Serana, are you going to let me loot this area without marching forward, aggroing more and more and more enemies like you've been doing? Furier has gold and the torn note, which we can read and take off our book list. It's one of two that are called the same thing. So, first, torn note. They fell upon us at dusk, dozens of them. The caravan guards were dead in moments. They took everyone else back to the pens, blinded those who tried to resist. One by one, they've taken the others away, feeding us to those monstrosities, or worse. I don't have much time left. Idis, my love, if you ever get this, forgive me. Furier. Okay. Now, I'd like to search the Charis Pen. Which I didn't get to before. There's another dead prisoner. Serana's other prisoner. All right, good. Now, that clears us up to here. Not sure if that's the boss chest or not, but let's search this hut. Nothing apart from the dead Falmer, that's good. We need to search over here, where apparently the prisoners were kept before Serana reanimated them. Another prisoner. Yet another. And one more. Oh, but look, this one's got chests in it. Oh, come on. Expert locked chest here. And that brings us over here. Inside this hut, nothing. Now we need to go over here. Nothing inside that hut. And now, once again, we're actually down to one way to go. Also nothing in that hut. And this tunnel is obviously the way forward.
Where'd you come from?
There's a Falmer. There's a Skulker. Has apparently fled a ways and is still running away rather than fighting. And there is the lovely chime telling us that Chillwind Depths is cleared. Well, let's take it off the clearable locations list. That's good. Now we can search, first of all, the hall where the boss Falmer was positioned. This altar here once had, I think Furrier actually was here, rather than in the cells. And Serana reanimated him. Plenty more ingredients, naturally. Notice all the skeletons down here with these Charis eggs. That'll do it for the underwater set. What about over here? Are there still more? Of course there are. Okay, that's done. Now let's take the ramp up and out. Gotta search around the throne, of course. I didn't want the tankard. Come on. You know better than that, game. Advances in lockpicking, we've read. Lockpicking skill book. That one is pretty obvious. There we go. And here's your boss chest. The hunting bow, remember, is a quest target. So when we're done in here, we'll go ahead and return it to Vilkas. And of course, we're done in here. now. So it turns out to be pretty good. I believe that we can't possibly get Vilkas's Dragon Seeker's quest until we move Dawnguard long enough to lose Serana as a follower. His Dragon Seeker's requires Vilkas to join us as a companion. And I don't see how that can happen if Serana is still with us. So we'll just have to wait
You're
a bit on that,
can get things done.
And that'll be fine.
What do you need?
Let's just go turn this
Please
one in.
Tell me you have news of my son.
And then we can forget about the
Looking
companions
for
a while again.
Check the Jarl's backside. That's usually where he stuffs
himself. We are just shy of being able to forget about him entirely. Just need to do Vilkas's last quest. We aren't there yet.
May the gods watch over your battles, friend.
I retrieved the family's hunting bow.
And it looks undamaged. They'll be pleased, I'm sure. And we're pleased with their money.
Yeah, it's I'm looking for work again, so.
All right, then.
Completed family heirloom. Let's go offload.
What a curious city.
We found a lot of stuff in there, after all.
So,
garden's in full effect, which means our fish hatchery probably is too. Love my porches. I love how we have non-hostile slaughterfish buddies. Slaughterfish eggs have not respawned yet. I should have known that was about to happen. It's all good though. Alright, now let's go offload for real. Then our next stop is the settlement of Dragonbridge, en route to Solitude.
Papa, let's play a game.
Sure.
What do you want to play?
Let's play hide and seek.
Okay. You stand right there and count to 10. No peeking. Ready? Go.
Girls' chests are still empty. That's fine. That time, most of our carry weight was actually ingredients, because that place was so loaded down with, mushrooms. Let's ditch all this too. Do I still have something else? Oh yeah, the Warhammer. Duh. And make a quick visit with Shavi.
Is there any? The gold is flowing nicely. Here's your half of the profits, my dear.
Now, getting to Dragon Bridge is pretty simple. We already saw the path to it. So let's return to Chillwind Depths. Get back to the road and just make our way north. Since we've already explored all this, it'll be nice and straightforward getting there, which I appreciate. Dragon Bridge itself is very small, only a few buildings to explore, and at this point, 9 people to visit. Ah, now everything rendered right, with the arrows appropriately stuck in the horses and on the wagon, at least until I touch one. But Dragon Bridge is very important because I can finally get a Penitus Oculatus helmet, which is the last little piece that I need in order to finish my endgame set of gear. My light armor. We already explored all over here. I will say, just before we cross the bridge, there are 2 things we should do. There is the Dragon Bridge. You can see why it's so named. It really is the only good way to cross the Karth River for a hefty distance in either direction. Before we head up there, on this side of the river, if we head west, just beneath and a little bit past the camp we can see up above us on the compass, we should find a gold vein. And again, this is where Hofengar meets the northern tip of the Reach. And here's the gold vein.
Valley, crevices, and hiding places. This is the kind of place where hermits and fanatics are.
And the other thing we need to do is peek around here. One of our treasure maps pointed us to a spot right around here, and it's pointed to 2 places. At the base of one of these trees, just to the left of the bridge. Should be able to find the satchel with a Dragon Bridge chest key. And then... if we duck down below the bridge and head down into the water, we can actually find the chest. Pretty easily. It's right here over to the right.
Get it now while we can.
Or just leave it alone. It doesn't make much difference. That's it. Now we can cross the bridge, discover the town of Dragonbridge, and start exploring. There we have discovered Dragonbridge. Can take it off our list. Few people over here. Let's chop wood once. Oh, can't use it because we're in combat. Well, alright. Let's pickpocket Michelle Lilvive and talk to her.
If you're looking for a room, you want the four shields. You look like you've seen your share of adventure. It's no easy thing to make a living in the wilds of Skyrim. Don't see many travelers out this way. This land's tough and unforgiving, but beautiful too. You hear all this talk about a war? I hope it never comes here. Need something?
Okay, let's talk to the kid. Clinton will leave.
One day, I'm going to be a soldier. Pa says I'm too young to fight in the war. But I can still help by patrolling the town. I wish I was a soldier. They get to travel and stay up late and have fun. Have you met Lucky? He's my pet goat, and he helps me patrol the town. Yes?
It's a little mean to kill Lucky, but I'm just gonna see if Fury works like it has before.
Hey, that's a valuable animal!
Leave me alone!
Nope. Although it might with quiet casting. Let's find out. Why am I looking at shouts? Who's even looking at me? Yeah, let's not. It's not worth it. Not now, anyway. I'll watch for another opportunity. In the meantime, let's pickpocket whore gear. Gold, two keys, and a lockpick.
Make yourself useful and chop up some firewood. There's a few coins in it for you. Working hard gives a man reason for drinking hard. Well, that and putting up with a wife like mine. You're a well-traveled sort. I can tell just looking at you. You been to Markarth? They've got a tavern called the Silver Blood Inn. Best ale this side of Skyrim. Money's been tight since the mill burned down. My wife won't let me forget it. They say a strong drink, a sharp axe, and a good woman are all a Nord needs to be happy. 2 out of 3 is not bad. Rest a spell. Can't work every minute of your life. Hmm?
I have firewood to sell.
Honest gold for honest work.
Naturally, that completes the chop wood favor for Horgear. Sounds like you're having some trouble with your wife.
Her name's Olda. If you've met her, then you probably already know what I'm talking about. I swear that woman is the most spiteful shrew in all of Skyrim. I think there's a chunk of ice where her heart ought to be.
How old is that stone bridge near the town?
Hard to say. It's ancient. That much we know for sure. It was here long before the town itself. I just hope the bridge survives the war. It's the only place you can cross the Karth River for a long way in either direction. Could be if one side wants to keep the other from coming across, they might try to knock it down.
Is your lumber selling better since the war started?
Damn right it has. Demand's never been so high. At least not since I built the new mill.
Alright, cool.
Alright then.
If you're looking for a room, you want the 4 shields.
So we have here a lumber mill. Pretty nice, pretty basic. Couldn't tell if we had fish there or not. Looks like we do. And looks like we got them all. Cool. Well, let's start poking around the town. Now that we're friends with Horgear, we should be able to explore the lumber camp at least. And probably Horgear's house, too, whenever we get to it. And don't expect to find too much in here, but always worth a look. 2 glass, baby. That'll take to Heliarchin Hall. Try and finish that place off. There's your lumber camp. Neil knows the path kind of splits into two. Left is the one that actually really takes you into and through the town. So let's go right first.
Destruction magic's fine. Just don't go burning down any buildings.
This one kind of takes you around, if anything. Sticks you here, just past Dragon Bridge to the north. Well, let's circle back down.
My cousin's out fighting dragons, and what do I get? Guard duty.
Here is the Lilviv family house. We aren't friends with him yet, but it's a pretty easy proposition. Let's just gather some crops. We'll sell him cabbage. That's all it'll take. Take the wheat for ourselves. We can check behind the buildings, too. Not gonna find much of anything on this side, though. Oh, finally. Let's try the actual road up through the town. We get the Penitus Oculatus outpost, which we'll check out soon enough. and we'll pause and chat with Azada and his amethyst, his gold, and his lockpick.
Seen some mean-spirited folk pass through lately. Thought I was rid of those sorts when I left Markarth. Welcome, traveler. Mind yourself in our town.
It's so bright out here.
We aren't a big city like Solitude or Markarth, but we like it this way. If it weren't for Michelle, I'd probably be dead in a Markarth gutter by now. Got a loving wife, a healthy son, and a patch of land to call my own. What more can a man ask for?
I have cabbage to sell.
Honest pay for honest work.
That completes the gather wheat favor for Azada Lilleaf. And let's check these others. Did you say you came here from Markarth?
I grew up an orphan on the streets of Markarth. I'd have died there too, but for the kindness of an old warrior named Logrolf the Bent. Logrolf rescued me and gave me enough money to get out of the city. I followed the Karth River north and came here. When I met Michelle, I knew this is where I belonged. I suppose that's it, really.
Do you worry about raising a family in these dangerous times?
Of course. Every night I pray that we don't get a visit from a dragon or that two armies don't show up to fight over the bridge. You ask if I'm worried. I'm terrified, if you want the truth of it. But I have to stay strong for my wife and children.
You mentioned mean folk passing through town?
Both the Imperials and Stormcloaks have sent riders this way, scouting the bridge and the lands nearby. They stayed at the inn but didn't pay. They said soldiers don't need to pay because they're risking their lives to protect us. And that's not all. They took a heap of our lumber, and one tried to have his way with my daughter. They think they can do whatever they want.
Now, I noticed a body down here. I find that alarming. But it looks like it's just the one from the altar over there, not a townsperson. So I think we're still good. Alright. Up here is the Four Shields Inn, which we'll check out in a moment. Four Shields Tavern, rather, excuse me. Here is Horgear's house, which I should actually already be able to check out. We should be buddies since I chopped wood for him, and we can get the one other.
Where is that lazy man?
Here's Lodvar. We can pick his pocket and talk to him.
Keep walking, stranger. Got nothing to spare for travelers nor refugees here. If you're looking for handouts, look somewhere else.
I didn't want that wooden plate.
If you want anything in this life. You gotta take it. Just not from me.
Okay. That does it for Lodvar. Let's go over here and chat with Olda after we pick her pocket. All she has is a key. All right.
Have you met my husband? Well, don't bother. He's a drunk. You're going to try and sell me something? Well, I ain't interested. Did my worthless husband send you? Got nothing to say to strange folk. Need something?
Your husband drinking too much?
He promised me, swore on his ancestors that he'd give up the mead. And what do I find out? He's been stashing drink in a cave nearby. He even has some wolves guarding it. I swear, I should just cut out his tongue. That would be the end of it.
I could get your husband's stash for you.
If you want to try, but I'll keep my dagger sharpened just in case. You can help yourself to any drink you find, but bring me the bottle of Dragon's Breath Mead. It's his favorite, so I know he has one there.
Steal the Dragon's Breath Mead for Olda. Does the presence of the guards here bother you?
No. I openly welcome the presence of armed strangers who have no reason to care about any of us. Of course it bothers me.
I'm sure it's only a matter of time until they seize our mill in the name of their war effort. Next thing you know, there'll be more guards, and then we'll lose our homes as well. This is just the start of it. Mark my words.
Does your family own the lumber mill?
My husband owns it. Barely. He'll lose it soon enough. He's behind on his loan payments, but he drinks all his money away just the same. Now we're deep in debt, penniless, and about to lose our sole source of income. All right, then.
Okay, Spirit of Nirn, we've read before. That's it for this house. Before we go out after the mead, let's check out the Lilvive house right quick. Should be friends now that we gathered wheat for Azada. Why they have a soul gem and high quality potions in here doesn't quite seem to add up, but it's all good. Here is the one we haven't spoken to yet, Julienne Lilvive. Golden lockpick.
Keep your hands to yourself.
I'm hoping to run my own inn someday. Fida's teaching me the innkeeper's trade. She runs the four shields.
Serana, quit shoving me.
Please stop looking at me like that. First the war, and now there's talk of dragons? What's next? Need something?
Alright.
Smile on you, friend.
That's all there is for here. Now we should check out the Four Shields Tavern. Maybe the last person we need to visit is Fida the Innkeeper.
Divines bless you. May the ground you walk quake as you pass.
Need to be careful in here, because there's not a good way to become friends with them. So we'll have to steal our useful stuff. Such as it is. Good news is there's not that much. I think I just grabbed a cast iron pot by mistake. I wasn't paying attention. Excuse me, Serana? Of Fury and Whole Gear, we've read. So let's pickpocket Fida. Just need the garnet and the gold. Usual hangers. And one more room to check. Pretty straightforward. I appreciate that. Right, let's
working hard, get... be careful.
Chat with Fida.
Fada's the name. I keep the inn.
Fada, excuse me.
Something different about you, I can tell. Hope you ain't here to cause trouble. The meals I serve ain't what I'd call a Jarl's feast, but they'll fill your belly. Seen a lot of travelers lately, mostly soldier nowadays. You met the Lilvievs? Quiet family, but they're the heart of Dragonbridge. I think the dragons are here to test us and make sure we're still true Nords. I was a barmaid at the Winking Skeever when I met my husband, rest his soul. Wasn't for him, I'd still be working there. Yes?
Alright, that's it. Now there's the Penitus Oculatus outpost, but let's take care of the Dragon's Breath Mead bit right quick. It's its own quest, so we'll actually need to independently turn it on. Oh, looks like now we can kill the goat. I like that. And he drops horns. Outstanding. I need two more, and I can't build anything until I get all of the last three, because it was the only thing I'm missing at Windstad is a small chandelier that requires three goat horns. So, two more. Let's just head this way. Cave's up here, you can see it. Well, you can see where we're being pointed to. We can run now. Gonna be a few ore veins to find along the way up there. The term cave is used a bit loosely here, in that you don't actually need to worry about going into anywhere. It's one of those fully exterior den type areas. So, as we truck up here, when we get above this two-level waterfall, we should see a path leading down to the left. We'll want to check that out.
Let's get indoors, or in a cave, anywhere.
Being able to actually kill something with my spear. Icy spear, I mean.
Done and done.
Alrighty, let's heal up. Anyway, note those archways up there. Also note the terrain shift. We're actually inside the Reach right now. But we're gonna stop in our tracks well before we get to any actual locations. So over here is where we can turn left. And head down toward the edge of the water. We do that really for two reasons. This Nirn root and this iron vein. And it won't hurt us to cross over to this little inlet either for Nirn root and a mud crab fight. Serana murdered the fuck out of that slaughterfish for me. That was kind of cool. Let's heal up a little. Let's get back to standard. Saw another mud crab over here. I know I did. Where did it go? That's the question. There he is.
Who's there?
Done and done. Search him too. Heal up again. Now let's head back. Not really anything else to do over here after all. Well, except some fish. That's always useful. Anyway, we head up here, and really right when you get to this mess, if you angle right, there's another iron vein. Easy to find, just tucked up here against the wall. Actually check this area out, you'd expect to find some cool stuff, but you won't. Just some hanging moss and a few mushrooms. Then if we keep on trucking, we get to the wolf den, where the dragon's breath meat is stashed, right here. We may have already fought the wolves. No, we didn't. That was awesome. So we get our three wolves. Some hanging moss above the cave entrance. In here, there's sure enough a big stash of drinks and the dragon's breath mead. Completed, steal the dragon's breath mead for Olda. Bring the dragon's breath mead to Olda. And what the game doesn't tell you is that you have a choice here. You can bring it to Olda, and she'll reward you with a leveled amount of gold. You can also bring the mead back to Horgir. He rewards you with a free boost in block, which I shouldn't have to tell you is a much better reward. So after I duck behind the den to mine this silver vein right quick, we are going to fast travel back to Dragonbridge. So any farther and we'll start running into Forsworn, because we'll be deep enough in the Reach. I'm going to find Horgir. Should be in his house this time of night, I think. But he's not. Anyway, they make it incredibly obvious that Olda is cheating on Horgir with this Lodvar fellow. There he is.
Working hard gives a man reason for drinking hard. Well, that and putting up with a wife like mine.
Olda wanted me to steal this dragon's breath mead.
Sure's crown, that woman never gives up. I guess that's why I married her. You're a real friend saving this mead from her. Here. Let me show you how to block a punch that might be coming from some angry spouse, huh?
So that completes the Dragon's Breath Mead quest. Failed to bring the Dragon's Breath Mead to Olda, but that's fine. Completes the, that's the last miscellaneous quest here in Dragonbridge. And, of course, it got us a free skill boost in block. Block went to 23. And it has three remaining boosts, all of which are, of course, quests. Last thing to do before we leave is check out the Penitus Oculatus outpost.
citizen?
Which currently has a single Penitus Oculatus agent.
What was that?
Who I will just kill. Destruction goes to 62. We get no bounty, and what we need off of him is the Penitus Oculatus helmet, which of course is on my gear list. It's the last important thing. Let's loot the building now, just for giggles. Don't worry, he's in here alone until we come back later on a Dark Brotherhood quest. Let's get all the goodies. And now, it's time to head back to Windstad for an offload. We're pretty well over the 1 hour mark anyway. Now we have important things to do. On my way by, I'm just going to put my goat horns and glass in here. Back for them later. Going to offload the other things I found. Children's chests. They remain empty. Smithing supplies. I have some straw that needs to go back outside. That's fine. For now. I need my crafting gear. Everything else out of here. Let's put the crafting gear on. I have a workbench here. That's great. Let's drink the potion of Fortify Smithing and use the leather to improve our Penitus Oculatus helmet. And let's drink our last potion of Fortify Enchanting. And enchant the helmet with Fortify Archery and Fortify Conjuration. Come on, there you go. We will rename it the Ultimate Helmet. And there we have all of our endgame gear. Awesome. So, because we still don't quite have heavy armor maxed, our nice ultimate helmet can wait with the rest of the gear. Our crafting gear can go back in here. I re-equip everything else. Now, let's grab our hearthfire supplies, because we found some glass. Let's make a quick run back to Heliarchon. All we have left to finish this off is, I think, two glass fixtures in the greenhouse. Anyway, in case you're wondering the reason that we waited to get a Penitus Oculatus helmet for our light armor set is because, just like a Falmer helmet, you can wear it along with a circlet. So, twice as many enchantments. Let's just duck in here. Let's make that one first. Alright. I need three more glass to finish Heliarchon. So let's go back to Windstad again. Drop our stuff off.
The gold is flowing nicely. Here's your half of the profits, my dear.
Let's do a quick visit with Shavi. Sure how I wound up with an Alto wine. I'll just drink it. That won't hurt anything. And now, with all that handled, we can head back to Dragonbridge, where we'll end the video, ready to keep going. Thank you. right, folks. Point myself this way, and that is gonna do it for this edition of Let's Play Skyrim. Next time, we're gonna keep exploring our way up towards Solitude. We're pretty darn close to it now, but there are a few locations to explore between here and there, and that's what we're gonna do. Until then, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoy my videos, please consider clicking an ad, liking, sharing, or subscribing. These things really help me out. Regardless, please know that I really appreciate the time you spend watching, and hope you have a fantastic day.